This here is an ESP8266. It's been rocking the Internet of Things world. It's a single chip that houses a computer and an integrated 802.11 Wi-Fi engine. Makes it so this little chip can connect to your home network and perform a whole array of tasks, which is just really awesome. Many times people will buy them in these modules because the modules themselves can be FCC approved. So this video is going to show what a range test between this and a home router is like. But one thing that in testing this I thought was really cool was when you connect one to the other. And if you're curious about that, you can click this video right here. I'm here. I'm at Hollins Ferry Road in Halethorpe, Maryland. And thanks, Jessie, for doing my camera work here. She's the person who got the t-shirt made for me. And a lot of people have wondered, how far do the newer ESP modules communicate? And in particular, I wanted to know, how much better is the ESP12-F than the ESP12-F than the ESP12-E? Because they advertise so much better range, four-layer process, all this whiz-bang stuff, and I don't know if I believe it or not. So here I have an ESP12-F, I have an ESP12-E, and I have this one-layer glass circuit board full of awful that I decided to do and just have an ESP on it and whatnot. This here is an ESP12-E, and you can tell because it's actually got the antenna part that goes across the bottom there instead of a whole bunch of little vias. So the ESP12-E was basically one of the first really good form factor ESP8266 carrier modules that was FCC approved. This here is an ESP12-F. It says a number of claims of improved other properties to it, but one of them was that it has better RF capabilities, and I don't know, I'm skeptical. So we're gonna take these two down this long road here and test them. Additionally, we'll be testing this design right here. So this is just a really awful glass circuit board with an ESP8266 on it and an itty bitty, just terrible, terrible tiny antenna. I mean, that thing's tiny. It's a 1206 size. It's just, there's no way this thing's gonna be any good. But you know what? Let's just see, how much does this whole like RF design and proper engineering really matter in the grand scheme of things? So here I have the ESP module connected up by serial to my laptop here, and I'm just watching it. So this module is reporting whether or not a packet is sent from this module to that TP-Link up there, and back to the module. And in that event, it will put a little X there, which means that this thing is currently communicating to the base station. Additionally, it shows the receive power, the RSSI, of this thing from the base station. So whenever the base station sends this thing a packet, this thing says, ah, I got a packet and its last power was 55 or whatever dB. One of the interesting things you can already see is very small changes can cause significant changes in the RSSI. So even from here, 44, to 52, 53, 54, that's a significant amount of power difference. And it's over just a few inches. And if you're curious a little bit more about why that is, you can click this video right here. That's also one of the reasons you can't use receive power to determine localization for things. So sorry everybody who's trying to think you might be able to use this to figure out where you are. At any rate, I'm going to take this, connect it up to that base station, and using a GPS app on my phone, determine how far this guy can talk to them. And so first up is the ESP12-F. So now I'm just going to go start walking down this road here, and we'll see how far I get. So I was just walking, and at 210 meters, I got a drop packet or two. I'm trying to find an orientation of the antenna where it'll actually drop some packets, but so I'm gonna have to say in open air, this thing's at least good. Oop, some more dropped packets there. Anytime the X doesn't display as a dropped packet, understand that this is actually using broadcast, so 802.11, the standard, would retry normally, but we're not doing that. So even if it's just dropping a single packet, you don't see it. But 210 meters, and it's just starting to drop packets. Let's see how much further this thing can go. Right now we're at 336 meters and it's kind of iffy. Like it's still working, it's still talking. But you can see a lot of times, a lot of orientations of this, it just kind of drops out. So it's kind of iffy. I don't think I would want to use this past 336 meters here. Just barely working. Most of the packets are getting dropped in almost any orientation now. We're up to 445 meters and it's just barely working. I guess I'll go a little bit further, but I think it's about to drop. Okay, I got a couple packets here, but it did actually drop out. So this thing completely, oh, it tried to reassociate. Don't think it's gonna go. So I'd say 470 meters is just the absolute limit. It's not getting an IP again. It's disassociated. Yeah, we're done. 474 meters for this ESP-12-F. We'll go back and try again with the 12-E. Okay, so let's try this again with the ESP-12-E. So this is supposedly not as good RF-wise or something. And we'll just see how far this thing talks. Same deal, same setup. X meaning it got the packet and the RSSI power. And just like before, a couple of just inches difference can mean a huge difference in the RX power. So let's go take this thing on a trip. For the ESP-12-E, we're only at 250 meters here, and already we're starting to get some trouble. I guess we'll just keep on going, seeing how good it is. So at least my first impression is it might actually not be as good. Maybe there is something to this whole RF design thing. I got a couple packets here, 425. Oh, it just dropped out. Yeah, I think this one's 425 is about its limit. A while back, I had a problem making a single layer glass PCB with an ESP on it. I thought that it's just something you could not do on a single layer. Turns out I was wrong, and it was a really simple thing. You're gonna have to look at the next video I'm releasing to find out what it was that made this work. At any rate, I have this, and it is a single layer board with an ESP8266 on it, and an itty bitty ceramic antenna. It's a little blue thing right there. And the design of this is just plain awful. It's not even a double layer board, so there's no ground isolation. And on top of that, there's a big ground plane running right behind the antenna. Everything about this board is just wrong. So let's see how well this thing does. Okay, so this single layer board I actually did to have 12 WS2812B LEDs. So it's still running the software that pings there and receives the response, so that's what these three lights are. But I can still send it some packets in order to send it, you know, make it do some other things, like this pretty little design here. Whoops. Oh yeah.
I feel uncomfortable.
We're only at 139 meters, and we're already getting some drops here and there. Actually, a lot of drops there. Up. Yeah, I guess it's orientation dependent. Everything is wrong, so. But yeah, I don't think this is going to go well, nearly as well as the other ones did. Like my Wi-Fi cup video, if this thing goes out of range, the lights get dimmer. So already you can see whenever it's not getting those packets back, this thing starts to fade out, and it's been spending a lot of time off, not very much time on. So 226 meters, really not all that many packets are getting through. So it's not very good here, but it's kind of getting through. If all you needed to do was say get a current or a temperature reading or something, you could probably do it from here, even with this awful design. And we're at 303 meters, so I guess we'll just see until it drops. Yeah, we're at 352 meters and it's pretty much tapped. It's just not coming back in. It dropped and that was it. So, I don't know. The really awful design does not work as well as the really good designs. But it's still interesting to see that you can in fact do this on a single layer without any kind of good engineering or anything. So I think I'm gonna be making a lot more single layer ESP8266 designs. Maybe some even more glass circuit boards with some ESPs on them. Up next is where we try to link one ESP to another ESP and see how far they can go. And it's acting like a wireless router. So I can connect to it with this guy, just like I did my laptop a moment ago. And this guy's connected to it.